Hi, I'm Kurt David, host of the show From Glory Days. Please join me as we watch the stories of Hall of Fame, All-Star, World Champion, and former professional athletes as they've transitioned from the pinnacle of their pro sports careers back to normal, everyday lives. Today's guest was a four-sport athlete in Texas. He went to UCLA on a football scholarship and became a college All-American in 1966. As a first-round draft pick by the Detroit Lions, our guest won the NFL's Offensive Rookie of the Year and had two Pro Bowl appearances before his seven-year career ended. Greater financial success followed our guest after his professional football career as he built an automotive empire worth over $500 million, making it the top African-American business in the United States at that time. Today's guest, Mel Farr, the superstar. When we come back, you'll hear how Mel went from running footballs to running some of the most successful TV ads ever.
From Glory Days, with your host, Kurt David.
Professional athletes give everything to win the game. After their glory days, most professional athletes want to give back to their communities. United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. With a remarkable background and impressive stats, Great Lakes Capital Fund is the perfect teammate capable of making big things happen. With this team, everyone wins.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
Hi, I'm Kurt David, joined by our guest, Mel Farr. Mel, great having you on the show today.
Thank you very much.
So growing up in Beaumont, Texas, it was lots of sports around you. I mean, you played not just football, but many different sports as well.
Yeah, I played all four sports and made All-State in all four. That was football, basketball, ran track, and baseball.
So it wasn't just one sport that you were outstanding in. It was four
all
sports.
Of, oh, yeah,
so four. Why football? How did you decide on football?
Because, I was probably better in football than any of the other, you know, mm-hmm. although, you know, I ran track and, but football was my first love. Mm-hmm. And in Texas, born in Texas, you know, football.
Football is a sport down there.
Absolutely.
Had an opportunity to go to UCLA. Things were different at that time, though. In the era you grew up, there was segregation, unfortunately, still going on.
Well, you know, Kurt, my brother who played football, he went to Wichita State before me, and Bubba Smith, I'm sure you know that name, Bubba Smith, Gene Washington, those guys, all three of us at one time was going to come up to State, Michigan State, and play at Michigan State. Duffy Daughter came down and recruited, he was recruiting Bubba, and he recruited me there, and I was going to go to Michigan State with.
So what changes? So you ended up in UCLA. How did that happen?
Well, a coach from UCLA came to Beaumont, Texas, and he said, "I want to recruit this guy Mel Farr." You know, and my coach got with him, and my brother, who was a great, outstanding high school football player, and he led the nation in punt returns. Sophomore year at Wichita State in Kansas, right? So I got a kind of feel.
The name was out there.
Yeah, and I got a kind of feel of recruiting, you know. Mm-hmm. And Kurt, one of the things that I did, I said, yes, I'll tell you what, Coach, I'll go to UCLA if you give my father a job at UCLA. So my father, I went to UCLA. Mm-hmm. My father went to UCLA. He mm-hmm. got a job there, and he retired. He retired from UCLA.
What was he doing there as a job?
He was working as a carrier for the
university.
Yes, because I wanted my father and mother to leave Old Races, Beaumont, Texas, because it was races back in the late 50s.
Different era at that time.
Totally, totally different.
So it was a great reason to go. I mean, we could have had you up here at Michigan State, but it was a great reason to go to UCLA.
And it's funny when you talk about that, it's because my junior year, we played Michigan State here. The first game of the season, and Bubba and Gene Washington, George Webster, those guys, and they say, "Hey, Mel, man, you made a mistake, man. We got a team, boy. This thing is great, you know." And they whooped our butts.
Oh no!
You know? And but you know what's funny, Kurt, is that that year We went on and we only lost one game, and so Michigan State and UCLA is in the Rose Bowl, right? And so, hey, this is the big thing. And Michigan State at that time, they said, hey, it had the best football team ever. I mean, they had George Webster, Steve Jude, some great players. Mm-hmm. And they were 10-0, and we were 8-2. And won, and we beat them in the Rose Bowl.
I
said, guys, look here, man.
Man, it all worked out for you.
Yeah, it worked out for you.
Well, in fact, it even got better after that. A draft by the Detroit Lions. Let's talk about that. The Lions saw you obviously too, and liked what you were doing. Played with the Lions. What are some of your best memories with the Detroit Lions?
You know, the camaraderie of the players. You know, I mean, our friendships that we made, you know, and the fact that, you know, you go to battle on Sundays, you know, so, you know, as a bond that happens with being an athlete, and being able to play with
some of the great friends, Hall of Famers,
with great players, you know.
Yeah, you mentioned to me personally about Lem Barney. Lem Barney was your roommate when you first got here to Detroit.
Yeah, Lem and I were roommates. I was number one draft pick, and Lem was number two. Lem and I were Rookie of the Years. It's the first time that they had an offense and defense Rookie of the Year. And Lem and I, you know, I don't think it's happened before since. Mm-hmm. You know, two players on the same team as defensive Rookie of the Year, mm-hmm. and offensive rookie of the year.
For the same team.
Yeah.
So, what else, you know, playing the teammates together? What other memories do you have about the game itself?
You know, going to battle. I mean, going to battle.
That competition.
Yeah, that competition. Just love to compete, you know, mm-hmm. what I mean? Hey, man, just love to go out there and, show the world what you've got, and show the guy that's on the other side of the ball, I mean, hey, I'm better than you.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that was one of the things that, kind of mad with, because I thought I was the best player in college football, mm-hmm. when I left out of college football. Mm-hmm. I mean, when I left out of UCLA. Mm-hmm. So I said, you know what, well, I'm going to show him. I said, I'm gonna go out and become Rookie of the Year, and boom.
Sure
I did
enough,
it.
You did
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
So you had that motivation at that point as well then. That's what motivated you to say, I'm gonna show these folks.
Well, I mean, that's the thing about the game, you know, mm-hmm. that, you know, and, you know, the, you know, competitive games draws the most competitive people, you know.
Yeah.
And that's the whole good feel of it, you know, go out there and hey, I'm gonna do my thing, you know.
Yeah.
You catch me if you can.
We're gonna take a quick break, but when we come back, we're gonna hear from Mel Farr where he got his superstar ads.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Great Lakes Capital Fund has built a game plan to provide a legendary kind of impact that will facilitate affordable housing to those in need and help build and better the communities that surround them. Together, the United Athletes Foundation and the housing and development experts at Great Lakes Capital Fund have the power of connecting professional athletes' vision, voice, and drive with asset management and strength. With this team, everyone wins.
Big statements are made with actions, not words. Go to the guys that work as hard as you do. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer on US 23, exit 149 in Whitmore Lake. The 24,000 square foot facility performs all service applications on tractors and trailers, light duty, heavy duty, single axle, multi-axle, dump trailers, and walking floors. No job is too big or too small. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer, 734-995-9600. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer, we do it right the first time.
Do you need a proven winner? Do you want to build a better team, create stronger leaders, and face change like a champion? Kurt David works with highly successful individuals, organizations, and businesses that at times face challenges with leadership, change, and developing passion. Go to KurtDavid.com and allow Kurt the opportunity to work with you.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
I'm Kurt David, joined by my guest, Mel Farr. Mel, 7 years in Detroit with the Lions. We talked about some of those memories. Great start, Offensive Rookie of the Year. Things changed over that 7 years, though, as far as for your football career. How did they change for you? What changed as far as that eventually those 7 years were up?
You know, Kurt, when I came into the league, I thought I was the best player, you know, and then I went out and proved it, but mm-hmm. became Rookie of the Year. And my second year, I go out and boy, I get a knee injury, you know, and had an operation on my knee, you know. And I said, wow, Mel, that could have been your last day on the football field. So, man, you need to go out and do something because we were not making the kind of money that you can retire on, you know. And so back in 1967, you know, when I came here, the city was on fire. There was a riot, you know. And after the riots, Henry Ford II said, you know, we're going to make automobile agencies, franchises available for African Americans. I said, oh, wow, man, that's the guy's brother. Mm-hmm. Who owns the Lions, you know? So, mm-hmm. you know what? I'm gonna go out and get myself a job over at Ford Motor Company, you know, because my dad was an automobile dealer in Beaumont, Texas, right? Mm-hmm. So I said, wow, you know what? I'm gonna go to Ford Motor Company and get
Ford.
Me a job,
yeah.
All right? And
so you were doing that during the off season. You were playing football for the Lions, working for Ford for 6 years, right?
Yeah. In off season for 6 years, I worked for Ford Motor Company, I went to University of Detroit at night and got my degree. You know, so
you were going to college, you were working a job, and playing for the Lions.
Yes, yes, yes. I mean, I feel like you're only going to earn today what your efforts and skills entitled you to, and no more. You know, so hey, you got to go out and develop that talent and effort and put forth efforts, and you can be whatever you want to be. You know, so when I retired after 7 years, and I didn't have to retire. You know, I retired because I wanted to retire. Because I wanted to become a businessman. I did what I wanted to do in football. Mm-hmm. You know, it got me to the place there. You know, I worked 6 years with Ford Motor Company to learn mm-hmm. the business, and so now I'm ready to be a businessman.
So you felt like at that time football was still there for you, but it sounds like you're ready to move on. That's what it was.
No, automobile dealers made more money than football players.
Oh, really? Tell us more. Okay.
Yes. Yeah, so that's what. So
that was motivation.
So that was my motivation. You know.
So by that 6 year working for Ford, you realized, boy, I can make more money doing this.
Yes. Then. Playing football.
So tell me about that transition. At what point did you make that decision, and how did that look for you?
Well, I after having the kind of injuries I had in the game, and the game was, it wasn't fun anymore because it was a chore getting out there to play. Mm-hmm. I got four staples and a screw in my shoulder, you know,
shoulder,
staples
knee.
In my knees and et cetera, you know, my hands all messed up. And I wanted to be a businessman,
mm-hmm.
you know, so I wanted to be an auto dealer. So that seventh year, I was through with football. I wanted to be an automobile dealer. So I retired, and I bought this bankrupt dealership on 10 Mile Road in Greenfield.
Mm-hmm.
It had been bankrupt twice, Kurt, you know. And my colleagues who I worked at Ford Motor Company said, you know, Mel, you know, that's the tough story. You know, no one has been able to make it go, you know. So I said, I'll tell you what, I'm going to get an experienced car dealer to become be a partner of mine, you know. So I got mm-hmm. a guy by the name of John Cook who had a Ford dealership on the east side here. And he became a partner. And after a couple of years, I said, Don, I'm ready now. I'll buy you out, you know. So I bought him out. And I changed the name of the dealership from Cook Far Ford to Mel Far Ford. And then I started calling myself the superstar dealer. And I said, Kurt, you know, the dealership had been bankrupt twice, and we were going bankrupt the third time when I bought my partner out, you know. But I said, you know, I'm gonna put a branding on this dealership, you know, and mm-hmm. I branded. Mm-hmm. I branded the Mel Far Superstar.
Yeah, and, well, we want to get into that, but back up a little bit. The transition from football to car dealer ownership. Tell us more about that. Was it difficult? How was it difficult? Even pro football, I mean, everybody talks about how difficult it is to leave pro sports in many sense as far as teammates, the fun, the money. But you know, the money you talked about already. You said you were making more money as a dealer than you were as a football player. So that part of the transition wasn't as challenging. But what about the parts that were challenging? What were some of the challenges that you faced before getting to that point of dealership for you as a player?
Look, I went to the after I retired,
mm-hmm.
so I went to the first game, all right, and wow, man, it was It's like a knife sticking inside me. Boom, boom, you know.
In what way? So like you wanted to be out there?
Yeah,
or?
Because, you know, I heard him say, you know, Charlie Sanders, Lynn Barney, man.
Mel Farr, you know.
So I went to that game, and I did not go back to another game that whole year.
It was
because
just too painful.
It hurt that bad.
Yeah.
I mean, it hurt, you know, to give up something that you spent all your life doing, you know. And you do it well, very well.
You know?
And to leave it, it's very difficult.
Exactly, and I hear that all the time. And so even though you had the success with the auto part of it, there was still that emotional attachment that you had to the game of football.
Yeah, you missed the locker room, you missed the camaraderie.
Has anything replaced it?
Traveling with the players and going out there on Sunday and
competing.
Yeah, competing.
Has anything replaced that for you?
Well, you know what, I started playing tennis.
Oh, okay.
I started playing tennis. Lynn Barney, Dave Bing, Joe Dumas, and I, we play tennis over my house every weekend.
So that helps that competitive edge. You guys getting together.
Hall of Famers, you know, playing tennis in our backyard.
I can only imagine that group out there. Well, we need to take another break, but when I come back, we're going to have Mel Farr tell us how he was one of the most successful African-American businessmen of his time in America.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Great Lakes Capital Fund and the United Athletes Foundation have built a game plan that will create stable and sustainable communities that include affordable housing and economic development opportunities. The United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. And Great Lakes Capital Fund has a superior track record in raising capital and managing communities they invest in. Together, they raise capital to invest in the future. With this team, everyone wins.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
We all experience financial bumps in the road. It's called life. And when financial challenges pop up, LOC team members are here. We specialize in debt relief strategies for our members. With lower fees and better loan rates, you'll realize the best place to do all your banking is at LOC Federal Credit Union. It's time to own your money. Visit us on the web or call to learn more.
Welcome to LOC Federal Credit Union. How can we help?
Yep, with Xfinity Internet, your family can use all their devices at once. Works anywhere in the house, even the garage.
Max, what's going on?
We're doing a tech startup. We're streamlining an algorithm.
What's Grandpa doing?
Hi.
Shh, Grandpa, you don't want to be an intern forever.
Sorry, Dad. We have to get back to work. We have a deadline.
We're going public!
The fastest in-home Wi-Fi for your entire family. Sign up for the X1 Triple Play and get double the speed. Only from Xfinity.
I'm Kurt David, back with my guest, Mel Farr. Mel, we talked about football and the dealership as well. That the money part of it wasn't a big a deal as most pro athletes deal with it. You know, today's pro athletes, that transition's bigger as far as the money part. But for you, you were making more money from your dealerships than you were as a pro football player. But there's still the emotional side of it. You still had the emotional side watching football. But tell us more about how that helped you now with the business side of it, because you wanted to be a business person.
Well, you know what? Boy, everything I wanted to do, I wanted to be the best at it, you know. And it was football. I mean, you take that competitive spirit in you, and you transfer it to something else, you know. And I what I did is I said, you know what, I'm gonna transfer that energy and effort into selling automobiles as I did in playing football. And you got to understand, man, being an athlete, I mean, you got that. You got
the passion,
the passion, you know, and that pride, you know, and that pride in performance, you know.
Is that what motivated you? Was that pride,
absolutely.
Performance, pride competitiveness?
Pride in performance, but you know, Kurt, there's a fine line between pride in performance, all right, and personal pride, and what you got to realize, and the athletes get that confused. You know, and they let their personal pride get in the way of them going out there and accomplishing something else.
Mm-hmm. So right? How did you handle that? How did Mel Farr handle that fine line between those two?
I realized that there was a difference.
How did you realize that? What happened?
Look. I'm going to not let my personal pride get in the way of me accomplishing my objective,
which was
being the best automobile dealer in the country, and then being the best largest African American business in the country. You know, and you know, Craig, it was funny when you mentioned that. Is that back in 1982, 81, and I had been in business about 6 years.
So regardless of the year, we know that.
I was in business about 6 or 7 years, mm-hmm. and we had an invitation, Black Enterprise, said, look, we're going to invite all of the top 100 African American business in the country to the White House, all right, with dinner with President Carter, you know, Jimmy Carter. And so, man, we went there and, boy, they said, the oldest guy there was a guy by the name of A.J. Gaston from North Carolina Mutual Life Insurance out of North Carolina. And the youngest guy was a guy by the name of Mel Ford, 33 years old, was there.
Wow.
You know. And I said, you know what? If I'm not the largest African-American business in the country, before I leave out of this earth, I would be a failure. And I set that goal.
That was a goal. That was an objective.
I set that objective that night in Washington, D.C., to be that. And hey, in 1996, 97, 98, I was the largest African American business in the country.
$500 million, right?
Yeah, $670 million.
Over $500 million.
Yeah.
And so what are some of those, attributes from sports that you applied? You talked about that competitiveness. You talked about that as far as just the drive, not being, you know, to have pride, and not pride necessarily in yourself. But what was the turning point that turned it from just having success to having hyper-success?
Wow, you know, it's that old thing inside of you.
Fire was burning.
Yeah, I'm a competitor.
Yeah,
you know, I want to be the very best at it. You know,
and you were.
So what happened is that, I thought I had a little smart, too. You know, and I done some things that are that's still around today that I said I couldn't. Patent it at that time, but that device you put on the car if you don't make your payments.
Ah.
The car won't start. Mm-hmm. Well, that was my invention.
No kidding.
You know,
you had that for your cars, so that.
Yeah, and if you think about it, you look at OnStar. OnStar is just a derivative of what I mm-hmm. did back in 1996 and 97 to give people an opportunity who have bad credit to own an automobile. Because I came up with the idea. I went in the bathroom. I cut the light on. Boom! Light. Wow. Mm. I said, you know what? An automobile should be like a utility. Everyone should have the right to own one, regardless of your credit. And so I said, well, you know, all the utilities, you're able to cut them off, right? So I said, well, look, let me see if I can find out a design that I can put on a car that would allow me
to do the exact same thing.
To cut the car off if they wouldn't make the payment. So, hey, I put that invention out there, and it ended up really destroying my business.
In what way?
I got sued, class action lawsuit. Spent millions of dollars, all right, because the people said that the car stopped on them when they were driving on the expressway.
Mm-hmm.
And what a big crap pot a lot of that was,
right?
Because the device was hooked up to the starter. Once the car started, it didn't have any effect on it.
But you had to deal with that part of it. That was part that you didn't necessarily want to, but you were forced to as a result.
Well, today if you buy an automobile and you, today on credit and you've got bad credit, they're going to put that device on you.
It's going to be
automobile.
On it regardless. So you're ahead of your time, in other words.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So I say, you know, wow, man, that invention was Mel Ford's invention, you know.
Yeah.
And I've had that ability to do that because it also allowed me back in 1981, I met with the president of Ford Motor Credit to allow me to put money in reserve so I can get customers who had bad credit an automobile, right?
Yeah, and so ahead of your time, like you said. Well, we need to take another commercial break right now. But when I come back, I'm going to ask Mel Farr to do his best Mel Farr superstar soundbite.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Professional athletes give everything to win the game. After their glory days, most professional athletes want to give back to their communities. United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. With a remarkable background and impressive stats, Great Lakes Capital Fund is the perfect teammate capable of making big things happen. With this team, everyone wins.
Hi, I'm Kurt David, back with my guest, Mel Farr. Mel, I couldn't do this without asking the best Mel Farr superstar soundbite. I mean, let's hear it.
And they cannot fly either.
Do it one more time. Let's hear it again.
And they cannot fly either. They cannot fly either.
How many times was that ad throughout Metro Detroit, and it sold cars?
Well, you know what? I'm walking down the street, man, and people walk by me and say, "Hey, they cannot fly either." You know, so it's been fun.
No.
And you guess what I'm going to do, Kurt?
What are you going to do?
I'm going to take the cape out of the closet.
Oh, really?
Yes.
For what purpose?
Well,
what are you doing now? What do you got something up going on?
Yeah, we've got a new business that I started with my grandson, who went to Brown University, and the business is financing car repairs, and it's we finance car repairs where your car is your credit.
Mm-hmm.
You got
that's your collateral.
You got credit.
Yeah.
You know. So that's what we're doing now, and we think that this is going to be a great, great business.
How do people get a hold of you for that?
Just dial 1-844-MEL-FARR.
That's easy. 1-844-MEL-FARR.
Yeah.
Well, great. Well, Mel, this show is about the transition of professional athletes, but more importantly, we want it to be about transitions in life. What advice would you have for anybody that's facing change or transition? What advice would Mel Farr have?
Wow. You know, you got to set goals. I mean, you got to set goals. You know, I say, you know. If you don't have goals and objectives, you know, I mean, that's what man was put on this earth to do, be happy, mm-hmm. all right? And happiness is not eating and drinking and being merry and everything is going my way with the absence of conflict or tension. Happiness is you come closer and closer to achieving your basic purpose in life, the happier you are. So I think you have to have a purpose. You got to have goals, you know? And you set the goals out there and you work towards them because that's happiness, you know? And that's the thing that I would like to leave them with. Hey, look, set goals and objectives. All right. And be tunnel vision and go out there and accomplish those because that's happiness.
And that's great advice from somebody who has accomplished that and still continues to accomplish that. So Mel, the transcending from a pro athlete to a business owner, a very successful business owner, how's that experience and how's that journey been for you?
Exciting. It really has been exciting. I mean, I've lived a great life. And still, you know, really
a lot of life left in you. You said.
Oh yes, a lot of life left in me, and I'm looking forward to working with my grandson and making this business that we're starting right now one that you know we all would be very happy of and excited about.
And that can it's here in Metro Detroit.
And be a tool to help individuals who need
that help right now. Mm-hmm. Mel, it's been great having you on the show. Appreciate you coming on.
Thank you very much for inviting me. I've enjoyed myself.
My pleasure. I'm Kurt David. That wraps up another show. Please join us again next time when we watch the stories of professional athletes unfold from Glory Days.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.